John, break it down for us in terms of surprises. Jeter, no surprise. Ken Rosenthal kind of characterized Larry Walker's as a modest surprise, maybe for some, not for others. Where are you with the class and maybe those that did not get in yesterday?
Yeah, I wasn't surprised. Thanks to Ryan Thibodeau, we have a pretty good understanding of where things are going. The thing with Walker was that he was going to be right on the button, right around 75. He came in a little bit over, so obviously he gets in. Jeter, the only suspense was he going to be unanimous? He was not, which was that one surprised me a little bit. It looked like Schilling moved up a lot, which I think we anticipated again, and I think he probably gets in next year. Clemens and Bonds had a rough year, I think, in the voting, and I am kind of dubious as to whether they will ever get in at this point. But Vizquel certainly made a nice move, as did Rowland and some others.
You know, John, at the bottom of our graphic, our page here, we have Billy Wagner. He made a big move.
Yeah, a lot of guys did. The ballot was not quite as stacked as it has in the past. There's a lot of good names still on that ballot, but not quite as stacked as it was, obviously, four guys getting in last year. That certainly opened things up a bit, and there's certainly a case to be made. I thought Jeter had to be a yes for everybody, and he was for everybody but one, and I thought 15 other guys had a reasonable case. I thought they were either borderline, not pejorative, but, I mean, obviously you got to be a great player to be borderline, or great player with perhaps a little bit of a steroid taint. So I thought Jeter was a definite, had to be, and the other 15 all had cases, including Wagner and Rowland and Sheffield and 12 others. So
I'm doing
good ballot.
I'm doing a lot of head scratching over Omar Vizquel getting as much pushback, as much resistance from some as he appears to. It's just befuddling to me. Is there a player for you that you think is pretty clear-cut Hall of Famer that for whatever reason others don't agree with?
Well, I think Schilling's a Hall of Famer. I know that he hasn't quite made it yet. I think he will get in. I vote basically a lot on the impact he had on the game, and I think his impact was huge, a big part of three World Series champion winners. I also think Andrew Jones and Scott Rowland are over the border for me. Great defenders, longtime All-Stars. Jones was a fantastic player with power when he was in Atlanta. And Rowland, a key player on a couple of playoff teams. So those are in for me. But I can understand, just like Wagner and Kent and several of the others, they're right on the border. It's a tough call. The only one who should not have been a tough call for anybody was Derek Jeter.
You know, John, you've been to a few Hall of Fame inductions. I've been to a few myself. With Larry Walker, Canadian, and Derek Jeter's celebrity, tell me what the zoo is going to be like in Cooperstown in July.
It will be huge. Obviously, Derek Jeter, one of the most popular players of all time, the biggest selling jersey ever, iconic player, New Yorker, and it will be huge. Obviously, Rivera drew a big crowd, and I think Jeter's crowd will be even bigger, even if he got one fewer vote.
Yeah, you know, Harold Reynolds suggested yesterday that Mick Jagger will be in attendance.
That's a hot take.
What do you
think
about
that? Well, Harold is very close to both Mick Jagger and Derek Jeter, so I would not shock me.
Right.
I don't know Mick Jagger myself. I know that doesn't surprise you in any way. So I really couldn't confirm that for you at this point.
You know, another little side discussion we had this morning, John, is the fact that we might not see another first ballot guy for a number of years. Perhaps Adrian Beltre, for sure Ichiro Suzuki. Are you along those same thoughts?
Yeah, I think Beltre's a first ballot guy. I think Ichiro's a first ballot guy. But obviously there were some fantastic players that have a little bit of a steroid connection. And I think those are going to be questionable at first ballot guys, A-Rod and a couple others. So, yeah, not a lot coming up, but some interesting candidacies. We've obviously had an influx of players get in the last 6-7 years, and I think that's terrific. I do think we have been too tough. I had pledged to vote for 10, the max, about 4 or 5 years ago, and I did that up until this year, and this year I decided on 5. I know some people voted for more, but that's where I stood.
This discussion, good for business every January, and we
Absolutely.
Appreciate the time with you, John, on at the Hall of Fame vote. Derek Jeter and Larry Walker, we'll be talking more about that as we continue. Jon Heyman, thank you very much for the time.
Thanks, guys.